pray that these graduates will be those who honor you with their lives, with their futures, with their talents, with their treasures. For years, these students have been preparing. The Lord, now we put them completely into your hands. I pray that you would bless our ceremony this morning. I pray that we would honor you in all that is said and done. In your name we pray. Graduates, you may be seated.
I will never forget the time at Stokia, the horse we were riding decided to lie down. helped and inspired each other over the years. Let us not forget that we should continue to do the same for others and to love just as Christ has loved us. I hope that our friendships will continue in the years ahead, that we will be there to support each other in our future endeavors. Congratulations to the graduating class of 2013.
Thank you all for coming. Whether you're a friend, a family member, or a random guy on the street, I welcome you all. I can honestly say I never thought that I would be giving a speech at my own graduation. Anyway, I found something to talk about. It was really hard to find. So I finally decided to just talk to you all about something that I have personally struggled with. Hold on to your pews, this might be about your ride. I'll start off by giving you the layout of my life. I grew up the youngest of four children. I followed my siblings to the Rock County Christian School, kindergarten through senior year. This was hard for me because everyone compared me to the three of them. I felt like I could never be as good, let alone better than all my siblings. I thought I would never do anything good enough to earn the right to be my own person. Eventually, I just gave up trying and started just doing what was asked of me. I wouldn't try to give my all or take any chances because I feared that I would never get to be the level of success that they had. This pessimistic mindset drew me down. Sadly, I did not only bring myself down. Throughout school, I unknowingly let this pessimism rule my identity and hurt those around me. Because I was chosen to be the leader of my class, I was meant to be the one to push us, but instead I pulled the class back fear of a lack of success. Luckily, I have friends that love me in spite of my bad thought process, but I wish I could go back and change some of the things I've done. I would like to thank all my classmates throughout the years for being so patient with me. I would like to thank a certain friend for telling me in private of my problem of pessimism, about how throughout these years it has become a form of pride and was tearing the class apart. So now that I had seen my corrupt ways as a leader, I had to change something. Now this is the part where I would love to say that I gained complete control of my problem. That is what I would love to say, but I can't. Pessimism is something that I still deal with, and through dealing with it, I have seen the problem in many other students. Many seem to think that they aren't going to succeed in school or life, and they shouldn't try the hardest. Instead, they sit back and just let life slip by. Why is this? Why can't we be the opposite? Let's be optimistic. How about we go into the world with the mindset that we can do the impossible, that we can change this world? Lately, the book of Philippians has been everywhere I turn. Personal devotions, church, senior trip. I think God is trying to tell me something. Thankfully, this last Sunday, my pastor, Pastor King, made this blatantly obvious. Please turn your pew Bibles to Philippians 4, 8 through 9. Don't worry, I'll wait. Seriously, I will. It's page 1140. I come from here. So how's it going? Okay. Finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable. If anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Whatever you have learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, put it into practice, and the God of peace will be with you. God is telling us to look to the things of Him, the things that are true, noble, right, pure, lovely, and admirable. There is a character in Pilgrim's Progress that only looked down at the evil in the world and tried to clean it up himself. Instead, he should have looked up to Christ and His glory, grace, and providence. We aren't meant to just be subpar. We are to look to Christ, see His characteristics, and be like Him, instead of looking down at the grime of the world. Looking back, every time I didn't try my best. Looking back, every time I didn't try my best, I denied praise to God. Look to the great things you can do for God instead of the wrong you can do by yourself. Graduates, do you guys ever truly think about how much the teachers of Rockingham Christian School put into your education? They do it because of two things. One, they love us to death. And two, they believe that they can make great Christians that will bring glory to God. Do you have any idea how much praise they are bringing to God through their job? To the teachers that have taught me throughout the years, thank you so very, very much. I'm sorry for the disrespect I gave you, and I thank you for your determination and love for me. Now, back to the students. No, we as individuals will not solve the problem. Yeah, I said it. You are not going to change the world. That is not humanly possible. But you can change those around you, and maybe even your neighborhood. Do you have any idea how many people you can impact by the end of your life? A lot. Yeah, a lot. I say that we go with optimistic minds and reach as high as possible. If we reach for our potential, God will reach down His arm and pull us even higher than we think possible. With God, we are strong and can succeed in Him.
As I'd be searching through the class, looking to see who's here, who's not,
I could never actually see Lucy. She was always ducking behind somebody else. Maybe not ducking, but I would call your name and out would pop your head out of seemingly nowhere with a bright smile on your face. And I look forward to hearing what you're going to do in the future ahead. Patty, Sarah, Miranda, Libby. I had a lot of good things to say about you. Then came the senior trip. Then came some very long and awkward band rides together. Don't know what to say about that. Between Patty belting out show tunes, I didn't know she had a voice before then. Libby and Miranda fighting about I don't know what, and I think I want to know. And Sarah, we're not going to go there. That might be graduate. But in spite of that, I will miss each of you. And I'm going to miss you all. Tim, who can forget the man who once earned the label the perfect man in one of our Bible classes, one of those rapid trips. Tim, it's my job to inform you that you're not perfect. But I have been very pleased to see that you put your trust in the one who is. Your leadership skills are admirable, and again, I look forward to see how God will use you in the future. Emily. There you are. Emily, you were the student I used to gauge how well my teaching was going. If you didn't know this. But I figured my lesson was going really well, and I must have been really interesting. If I could get Emily to look up from her book for a few minutes, I knew whatever I said really must be doing well. So, Emily, thank you. You're an intelligent girl, I'm sure. God will use that ability and that ability in great ways. Zach, you're a man with many talents. Very few people can throw together a promotional video a few minutes before it had to be done. But you and Tim and Lance did just that. I'll pray for you often as you use your many gifts in service to our country and to the many things that lay ahead. And finally, Lance.
Compared to a chicken and an egg. You
take the chicken out of the egg too soon, and you have a delightful breakfast, but it's not good for the chicken. The purpose of the egg is to shield it, to protect that chicken as it forms and grows stronger. But eventually the purpose of that shell is to break, and for the chicken to come out fully formed and ready to face the elements of this world. That has been our purpose here at Rockland Christian School. Your time here has been a time that we have spent in preparation for this moment. But now it's time to crack open the shell and to release you into this world. John 17. I won't be like Lance. I won't make you turn in your cheap Bibles, but I'm a little flexible. John 17, verses 6 through 19. I have manifested your name to the people whom you gave me out of the world. Yours they were, and you gave them to me, and they have kept your word. Now they know that everything that you have given me is from you. For I have given them the words that you gave me, and they have received them and come to know in truth that I came from you. And they have believed that you have sent me. I am praying for them. I am not praying for the world, but for those whom you have given me, for they are yours. All mine are yours, and yours are mine, and I am glorified in them. And I am no longer in the world, but they are in the world. And I am coming to you, Holy Father. Keep them in your name, which you have given me, that they may be one, even as we are one. While I was with them, I kept them in your name, which you have given me. I have guarded them, and not one of them has been lost except the son of destruction, that the scripture might be fulfilled. But now I am coming to you, and these things I speak in the world, that they may have my joy fulfilled in themselves. I have given them your word, and the world has hated them because they are not of the world, just as I am out of the world. I do not ask that you take them out of the world, but that you keep them from the evil one. They are not of the world, just as I am out of the world. Sanctify them in the truth. Your word is truth. As you sent me into the world, so I have sent them into the world. And for their sake I consecrate myself, that they also may be sanctified in the truth. I just want to look at three brief points and then we'll be out of here. Well, I think that's one of the things, but I'll be honest. First, notice that in this passage, we have been sent into this world. Just as the Father has sent Christ into the world, so Christ sends us into the world. This world is wicked. This world is difficult. This world is challenging. This world has rejected God. This world is filled with sin. This world is yours. This is where God has placed you. Sometimes we talk about avoiding worldliness, but we cannot, we must not avoid the world. This is your mission. This is your job. In one sense, you are to be worldly. You are to be living in this world, but not of the world. But you have been given a commission by Christ. You are to be a reflection of the Father. You are to be shining lights in this world of darkness. We are not of this world, but we belong to Christ. Our identity is wrapped up in that concept. We belong to another kingdom. We're pilgrims on this journey, but this journey is not accidental. God wants us to be here. You are to be in the world. Our goal for you, therefore, is not just to be preachers or missionaries or evangelists. We want you to be more than that. We want you to be nurses and dentists, graphic design artists. We want you to be accountants. We want you to be bookkeepers. We want you to be janitors. We want you to be any occupation that's out there. But we want you to be a bookkeeper who is absolutely in love with Jesus Christ. We want you to be a bricklayer who craves to learn from the Word of God. We want you to be a hairdresser that is in love with the local church and seeks to reach his or her community through that church. We want you to be whatever profession you are, to be living out your faith day to day. If you can do that, this world won't know what to do with you. This world won't know what category to put you in. If you can do this, you will be what we long for you to be, what we dream for you to be, what we need you to be. Ambassadors of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's our goal for you. We want you to be shining lights pointing to a kingdom that is yet to come. Even though this world knows nothing of, but so desperately needs. You are to be that light in the midst of darkness. But light means nothing if there is no darkness. This passage we looked at also gives us some help in that journey, that ambassadorial mission. First, we're told that the Father is receiving prayers from us, from none other than His own Son, our elder brother, Jesus Christ. Jesus is daily interceding for His own. He is praying for us. But notice, He is praying for us. He's on our side. He's wanting to strengthen us, to encourage us. But the key word there is us. He's not praying for you. He's not praying for me. He is praying for His people. We were meant to live in community. You are leaving Rock County Christian School. But you are not leaving. If you are a child of God, you are not leaving a community of believers. We've been told not to forsake the assembling of ourselves together. We are to be surrounded by those who love Jesus intensely and are devoted to the sacred scriptures. We need the church. It's not just an option. We need the encouragement. We need the edification. We need the instruction. We need the accountability, and sometimes we need the rebuke. But that church, that body of believers, that community of faith provides us. In this ambassadorial mission, we've not been left alone. We've also been given the Word of God. We're going to be sanctified by truth. And Jesus says, just to make sure we understand, your Word is truth. We are to be Christians who seek out the Word of God. We are to allow that Word to transform our mind, to transform our actions, to transform everything that is us. We are to be conformed to the image of Christ. And that's an image we see in the sacred scriptures. As we seek to make a difference in this world, God's given us His Word. He's given us the church. Every year, it's kind of funny to see seniors who can't wait. This class probably has taken that to the next level. Can't wait to call their teachers by their first names. We kind of already started that with the signature. And we can laugh at that. I don't know why it's that. Maybe we're just used to, you know, trying to show respect or whatever. But, you know, there is actually a reason why. At least I encourage them. Because at this point now, our teacher-student relationship is over. You are not merely our equals. You are our friends. And not merely our friends, our co-laborers together in the gospel. Welcome to the future. Welcome to the journey. You're just beginning. I'm glad that you're along for this ride. I need you, just like you needed me. We need you to be about this ministry. So class of 2013, my challenge to you is to be in this world. Do not hide from this world, but challenge it. Live out your faith. Yes, you will not always be successful in that endeavor, but that's what keeps this world. They sometimes need to see us fail from time to time. They need to see your struggle. They need to see a God who saves and uses imperfect men. Join us in this journey. As we seek the reflections of God's love and dispensers of His grace, do Do not merely change the world, but be a testimony of a world that is yet to come. Be ambassadors.
Thank you, Mr. Thompson, not only for the very fine message, but for all you've done for these this senior class over the last 5 years. I think it's really neat, the bond that you formed, and I'm sure they'll never forget the times that you've had together. At this time, I'd ask our administrator, Mr. Beefus, and our school board president, Mr. Grindel, to come to the platform, please. Graduates, please stand. Mr. Beefus, Mr. Grindel, these students have completed the requirements for graduation, and it is our privilege to confer their diplomas as graduates of Rock County Christian School. At this time, I'd like the parents of the graduates to please stand. Emily Carroll. Emily is the daughter of Andrew and Melissa Carroll. She's attended Rock County Christian School for 2 years. Emily's participated in choir, the crew for the school play, and she was a quarter scholar at Boyd College. Emily plans on attending Olivet Nazarene University in the fall. Emily would like to thank her parents for encouraging her to get better grades and for always being there for her, especially when she needed it the most. Emily attends Rock Valley Chapel, and she's graduating cum laude. Emily Carroll. Zach Champlin. Zach is the son of Jess and Wendy Champlin. He's attended Rock County Christian School for 3 years. Zach has participated in soccer and baseball. He plans on joining the Navy as an advanced information technology technician. Zach would like to thank his parents for putting up with him and supporting him. Zach attends Central Christian Church. Zach Chandler. Family. Tim has participated in soccer, basketball, baseball, golf, the school play, the chapel praise and worship band, and he was the New Lions Club Student of the Month. He plans on attending the University of Wisconsin at Rock County in the fall. Tim would like to thank his parents for always being there and pushing and encouraging him, supporting him, as well as giving him a good foundation. Tim attends Roxbury Church of Christ and is graduating cum laude. Tim Grindel. Elizabeth Irving. Libby is the daughter of Joseph and Angela Irving. She's attended Rock County Christian School for 7 years. Libby has participated in volleyball, basketball, 2 school plays, choir, mission trips to Costa Rica and Kentucky, and cooking and softball clubs. Libby plans on attending the University of Wisconsin at Rock County to pursue a career as a nurse practitioner. She would like to thank her mom and dad for raising her in a Christian home where they can talk about anything. Dad, thank you for being supportive of me and my extracurricular activities, though things could get crazy. Mom, thank you for encouraging and guiding me when I was upset about whatever. I love you both more than anything. Libby attends Hope Evangelical Free Church, and she's graduating cum laude. Elizabeth Irving.
Choir,
chapel praise band, newspaper, yearbook, and softball club. Miranda plans on working next year to raise money for college. She'd like to thank her dad for everything he's done for her. She really appreciates it. She would also like to thank the people who have been like parents to her, Sandy Klein and Ray and Annette Jewell. Miranda attends Roxbury Church of Christ. Miranda Snyder. This time I'd like to introduce the junior class sponsor, Mr. Bruce Mulder, who will close us in prayer.
Let's all stand together to be dismissed. And I'm assuming that one of the graduates will out first before we go out. Let's pray. Father, you are the great and you are the mighty God. Father, it is good gather together in your name to celebrate what you've done in these students' lives. And Father, we look forward to the day when we can meet them again and see how you're working in their lives, whether they're in school, in their jobs, as they found spouses, as they get involved in their churches, and as you have worked in their lives in the future. Father, more so, we look forward to the day we can be joining with them in eternity. in your very presence, praising you for the great God that you are. Dismiss us now with your blessing. Father, as we join in fellowship together for refreshments, we give praise to you for what you've done here. Thank you for your presence. In Christ's name we pray.